Obamacare, by the numbers. Have you ever wondered why Republicans hate Obamacare so much? They made the Affordable Care Act the most politically charged topic of Barack Obama's presidency. The goal was innocent enough: provide health care coverage for working class families and folks who had slipped through the safety net. Yet the bill was hugely controversial, passed by a single vote in Congress, nearly collapsed under its weight during the rollout, and barely survived a Supreme Court challenge. It was by no means a simple birth. Let's try to understand why. The principles of the ACA are well known by now. Legal residents who do not already have health insurance through their employer or some other means are eligible for coverage via Medicaid for those at low income levels or through the health care exchanges for those of greater means. The exchanges are run by the states and allow people to compare private health insurance plans side by side. That is, give everyone a choice. The emphasis on choice was a nod to conservatives who hated the idea of a single-payer system and wanted to promote free market competition. Healthcare exchanges are actually a Republican idea. The ACA further helps low-income people pay for their insurance. Everyone must contribute according to their income, and the difference is paid by the federal subsidy. Personal responsibility is also a Republican idea. Several elements of Obamacare have proven to be quite popular: universal coverage, comprehensive benefits, subsidized premiums, prohibitions on denials for pre-existing conditions, prohibitions against annual or lifetime caps, and coverage for young adults up to age 26 on their parents' plans. These two elements have not been so popular: the high costs of premiums and co-pays, and the individual mandate. The high premiums are due to the high cost of healthcare in general and are partially offset by subsidies. Of course, the insurance companies do set their own prices. The second source of unhappiness was the individual mandate, which was removed by Congress in late 2017. The ACA mandate required everyone to purchase health insurance or pay a federal penalty. The argument against the mandate was that by pressuring Americans to buy health insurance, the ACA trampled on personal freedom. Some would say that this limit on choice was distinctly un-American. Nothing could be further from the truth. In fact, the primary purpose of the mandate was actually to prevent freeloaders, or healthcare moochers, those who can afford to purchase health insurance but choose not to, because they can get away with it. It's easy to be a moocher. If you choose not to pay into the system now, your emergency needs will be covered by your fellow citizens, because hospitals, by law, must treat all emergencies whether you have insurance or not. If, later on, you develop a chronic illness like diabetes, heart disease, or cancer, you can always join the system at that point, because the current rules allow it. Imagine the poker player who does not ante into the pot, then joins the game on the third hand, hoping to reap all the winnings. That is our moocher. And Americans have not been kind to moochers. It's like waiting until a car accident to buy car insurance, or waiting until your house burns down to buy house insurance. Nowadays, you can't even register your car without insurance. You can't even get a mortgage without insurance. These are mandates, and for good reason. Without mandates, some people would take advantage of everybody else. Now, let us turn to the evidence. How has Obamacare fared by the numbers? There's no denying that the main goal of the ACA, to improve insurance coverage, was a smashing success. After full implementation, 20 million Americans gained insurance coverage under the ACA, and the beneficiaries were widespread and diverse, including 6 million young adults, 9 million white Americans, 4 million Hispanic Americans, and 3 million black Americans. Further, the proportion of uninsured Americans dropped from 16 to 8.6%, which is the lowest rate in America's history. And what about costs, since one of the goals of Obamacare was to slow down the growth in healthcare spending? Here is a graph of total healthcare spending as a percent of our economic pie over the past 60 years. Notice how healthcare keeps taking a bigger chunk of the pie as time goes on. But the flattest part of this curve is on the far right, which is the era of Obamacare. That's right. Obamacare produced the slowest increase in healthcare costs of the past six decades. Isn't that amazing? While adding health care coverage to 20 million more Americans, the ACA actually slowed the growth of total health care spending. It was like magic. Even better, the Congressional Budget Office concluded that Obamacare came in under budget, so much so that repealing Obamacare would add $98 billion per year to the federal budget deficit by 2025. Still, health care is very expensive. So what can we do about the continuing high cost of insurance premiums? Well, why not take advantage of Medicare, which costs 30 to 40% less than private insurance plans for all the same benefits? That is full coverage at private hospitals using private doctors and private pharmacies, yet with lower premiums, deductibles, and co-pays than insurance companies on the exchanges. I think we have just figured out how to solve the outrageous cost of healthcare choices. The plan we need to add is an option on every exchange. Medicare. That's right. Add a Medicare choice as another insurance option. Those who find it attractive could freely choose it, and everyone else could stick with their own plan. The government does not need to dictate the outcome of any competition between private and public health insurance. Americans can vote with their wallets. In summary, Obamacare provided health insurance to 20 million Americans while slowing the rise of overall healthcare spending and coming in under budget. A most remarkable trifecta of success. And how did the Republican Party respond to the ACA's success? Not too well. It's no secret that they were hostile to the ACA from the beginning and have never stopped trying to bring it down ever since. So why do Republicans hate Obamacare so much? Because Obama stole their idea. He and his colleagues expanded universal coverage with private health care covered by private insurance using market principles to promote free choice and threw in an individual mandate to guarantee personal responsibility, and then made it a smashing success. And the Republicans still want to take it down. How ironic. Actually, it is more than ironic. To oppose a measure that expands health care according to the governing philosophy of your own party, and to attempt to sabotage something that has improved the lives of tens of millions of Americans, demonstrate a level of cynicism that is unmatched in politics. In the healthcare arena, it is no longer clear what the Republican Party actually stands for. If you believe Obamacare is a good thing, make sure you vote in November. Hi, I'm Nate Link, and I hope you are enlightened by this video essay on Obamacare. For more video essays on economics, health, and politics, please check out my website at snickersnack.com. Thank you.